Use that.
Okay. Let everybody hear you.
I know. Okay.
Hello? I come to you today as a parent and as a citizen and a PTA member and as a Zapatista in the Dallas community. I first encountered segregation in our school system when I was 14 years old. The segregation I'm speaking of came to me by way of deportation. I lost many friends I never saw again because of deportation. And as an adult, I am witnessing another form of segregation and classification in our school system today, affecting our African American and Hispanic communities. Earlier this year, Dallas Independent School District City Council decided to close 11 schools in South and East Dallas, whom are populated primarily by minority and immigrant families. When next school year starts, 1,198 African American, 38 Asian, and 1,491 Hispanic students will be displaced from their schools and communities to attend a new charter school. In East Dallas, where I live, 3 schools are closing and 2 will remain open, displacing 44 African Americans and 827 Hispanic students and their families. The 2 schools that will remain open have a diversity population of 57 African Americans, 40 Asian, 306 Hispanic, and 863 Caucasian students. I consider this segregation and classification of our community. I brought photographs for you guys to look at. You can pass them around. My son attended 1 school that's closing and 1 school that's remaining open. Please feel free to look at the photos. It's quite obvious in the photo that you can see exactly what's going on in the school system.
Let's see.
I have a newspaper article too where Lakewood Elementary rezoned themselves 2 years ago to where they don't have to take these students in. This is from 2010. You can take a look at this as well.
Yes, let me get it back on that.
I feel this is a terrible thing to do to our students, parents, teachers, and our community. And they call it a budget cut. It's going to cost us money to rebuild, rehire, relocate students and teachers. If the district is mishandling our local taxes, then why should we give them more money? But from the state, no less. And to sustain, they're not sustaining our awarded schools. These schools have been awarded. They've got blue ribbon, exemplary, and recommended, both the ones staying open and the ones closing. Sorry to take up so much of your time.
Not at all.
That's right. You're adding to it.
Sorry. Some children will be denied access to these charter schools, but you have to have no disciplinary record, you have to have excellent attendance, and you also have to be approved into charter schools. So where are the children going to go that aren't going to be approved at the charter schools? And what does this teach our children? When faced with making a similar decision as an adult, is my son going to find it acceptable to classify and segregate his community in the future? Charter schools are overcrowded, they're understaffed, and not a lot of teachers want to teach at charter schools. I come to you because I feel like we shouldn't let this happen or allow it to go unnoticed. I'm filing a complaint with the Texas Education Agency myself and looking into talking to a higher level if necessary. I feel this is a violation of the civil rights of our children and to an unequal education to our children. I urge you to contact your local school. Go to your teachers. Go to the counselors at the schools, the principals, ask them if they need help, because if the school district's going to cut funding, that's the first way they cut the school out of the system. And this is wrong. What is my son going to learn from this? We're relocating a whole community of African Americans and Hispanics to a whole other section of town that they don't live in. I say ya basta.